It's an old chestnut, but amazingly a dilemma that scores of Australian families still face. Is it worth going back to work after the birth of a child when, for many, childcare fees are frankly brutal? That said, we hear they're actually going to go up again next year. Here's Emma O'Sullivan.
Manon Davies has two of her children, Anton and Romy, in childcare 2 days a week while she looks for work.
But my dilemma is that I want the childcare cost to be as low as possible in order to make going back to work worthwhile. But I want the childcare to be of a high standard, and quality costs money.
That's exactly what childcare providers are grappling with as they prepare to meet new national standards, which they warn will make it more expensive for parents.
Well, our childcare costs are our second biggest expense after the rent. So it's a huge part of the budget.
The changes are known as the National Quality Framework. States and territories agreed to the reforms back in 2009. From January next year, centres will need more staff and they'll have to be better qualified. To catch up to the new standards, one Melbourne council has predicted it will have to lift fees by up to $25 a day, a massive difference compared to modelling for the federal government, which forecast the changes will cost just 57 cents extra a week in the first year.
This is modelling which Access Economics have done and they stand by. We know that this is about national averages, but we also know that the changes we're talking about are gradual and they're modest changes.
The not-for-profit group Early Childhood Management Services caters for 5,000 children. Its CEO says while reforms are overdue, they're expensive.
We're looking at increases in the vicinity of $10 to $15 a day. We're very keen to make sure that doesn't become a barrier for parents accessing a service.
Currently, most states require one staff member for every five children aged under three. But when the new rules come in, that ratio will change to one for every four.
That does require careful planning and implementation to make sure what is a good idea doesn't have unintended consequences for families who are denied access to services by the cost increase, or services need to reduce the number of places, therefore it'll have a negative impact on workforce participation rates.
For most families, the federal government absorbs 50% of fees through its childcare rebate.
We're investing over $20 billion over the next 4 years. I'm happy to stand by that record. We know that childcare needs to be affordable. We know it needs to be accessible. But we also know that parents deserve peace of mind that it is quality care that their children are receiving.
If worse comes to worse, Manon Davies believes mothers like her will pull out of the workforce because the balancing act will become too hard.
I think we'd have to think twice about sending them. There's a point at which the benefits of working is outweighed by the cost of childcare, so if it were to go up by that much, I think that would be a real problem.
Emma O'Sullivan with that report.